Let's move on to group number five.
Groupe de travail numéro 5, donc, et quel en est le thème? Je ne vous l'ai pas encore donné, le voici cette fois-ci.
Global levers of change to foster one sustainable health. That is the theme for the fifth group.
Durable pour tous. J'accueille en studio.
I am proud to welcome Eric Comte.
Bienvenue sur ce plateau, je vous laisse vous installer.
Merci de me recevoir.
Thank you for your invitation.
Le directeur du Geneva Health Forum. Nous allons revenir vers vous. Avant, nous allons parler avec Andrea Vinclair.
But before asking you a few questions, I have some questions for Andrea Winkler.
Vous êtes co-chair de la commission.
You are co-chair of the Lancet Journal. How will you work in collaboration with the other members of this working group? What will be your approach?
Well, thank you very much for the invitation to this launch. And just a small edit, I'm the co-chair of the Lancet One Health Commission, which is actually a high-level scientific commission that is mandated by the science journal, The Lancet. And I think I very much represent what we have worked on within this commission for the last 2.5 years. And I'm happy to present some of our thoughts here today. Also very happy to see some of our commissioners in other working groups and in this working group. So I can put it actually in very simple terms. One Health must become the new norm at local, at regional, but foremost at global levels. And that includes the whole of society. So we need a whole of society approach in all sectors, including politics, public and private sectors, business, academia, science, education and vocational training, and of course, civil society at large. It must spread from grassroots to the decision makers. And to achieve all of this, we need good governance skills. I think this is really essential. And diplomatic maneuvering in the One Health space so that the different stakeholders are happy to sit at the same table and feel welcomed. We need to make them understand the added value that One Health holds for all of us, and which is not only monetary. We can talk about this later, of course. And we need to make bold proposals on how best to implement One Health for our joint future. So should we rethink the economy, for example, and put One Health at the center? Maybe be quite daring and say, well, argue for a One Health degrowth in exchange for One Health profits. Sorry, to argue for an economic degrowth in exchange for One Health profits. And for our big plans for the future, be it the post-2030 agenda or the international health regulations, a pandemic treaty, so we as the One Health Society need to demand that One Health is actually firmly woven into all these global agendas, not just on the sidelines, but as an integral part. And last but not least, we have big plans, and these plans that need to be very timely. So let's integrate technological innovation throughout. But at the same time, let's not forget the most vulnerable populations and keep One Health equity as our mantra deep in our hearts throughout our processes. Thank you very much.
Vinclair, co-chair de la commission de la revue Lancet sur le WAP.
Andrea Winkler. Andrea Winkler, thank you very much. One Health should be the new norm. Okay, Eric Comte.
comment est-ce que vous comptez mobiliser
How do you intend to bring local communities together?
Aller vers cette santé durable pour tous. Comment est-ce que vous pouvez imaginer votre rôle?
How do you imagine your role within the Geneva Health Forum?
C'est sûr que la situation du Covid qu'on a vécu ces derniers temps a mis en évidence la fragilité de nos systèmes de santé.
It's obvious that COVID-19 revealed how fragile our health systems were. And our developing models were just not sustainable. The environmental failures are more and more and cannot be sustained. So we'll need to work on a new model. It will not be with a snap of the fingers. We'll need to find pillars in order to find dynamic actions in favor of a sustainable health. We have found so far six pillars. First of all, is the empowerment of local communities, how to involve local communities, how to make sure that we can talk with them and they can act for their own change. Nothing will be done without the local communities. Secondly, we need to tear down walls. The WHO needs to work closely with FAO, with CNUD, with OIE, and other UN organizations. And health ministries around the world must work with environment and agriculture. We need to promote open science. We need to work in a multidisciplinary approach as well. Thirdly, we need to train people. We need to integrate new challenges in a new knowledge in the training of the next generation. Fourthly, financing, taxing, investment are important factors that we need to change in order for attitudes to change. Fifthly, digital. New communication technologies exist, new data collection and modelization exist, and they must be used to have a better follow-through of our action. And lastly, we need to have everybody on board. We have bad habits, and it's difficult to change a bad habit, and the decision makers will not do much if the population is not here to request those changes. So those are 6 points that I would like to present to the group, and I'm sure there will be others. I believe that the networks we are developing will help us to dig deeper and set up concrete actions. Thank you, Eric Comte. Indeed, you advocate bringing together the different communities and working around those six themes. Our next guest is Ole Peter Ottersen. You're in duplex from Sweden.
Comment est-ce que votre institut va agir concrètement?
How will your institute work concretely, the Karolinska Institute, to participate in this fifth group?
Est-ce que vous nous entendez, Ole Peter Ottersen?
Yeah, first of all, I'm very happy that I'm now part of this working group and this excellent network and initiative. This is really what we need given the challenges ahead. So first, I have three different points that I think are relevant to the discussion at hand. And these three points are coupled together, certainly. Yes, we need to work across communities, as was just said. But the first point is we need to work across sectors, obviously. We have to reach beyond the healthcare sector to really tackle the challenges that we're facing now. Health is cross-sectoral or multi-sectorial, and we have to realize this in the work ahead. The second point is coupled to the first one, and that is that if we realize what is the case, that health is multi-sectorial, stretching across political sectors, then of course we have to look at the political determinants for health. That must be a very important part of our work. I was chairing a Lancet commission on this very issue, the political determinants of health, 3-4 years ago. And the results and conclusions of this Lancet commission are still valid and even more relevant today than they were 3-4 years ago. The political determinants of health are essential in order to know how we can implement new data, how we can ensure that our knowledge is translated into new policies for a better health. The third point is coupled, as I said, to the two first points. We have just established, in order to be synergistic to this initiative, we have just established at Karolinska Institute a science center for health emergency and pandemic preparedness, a health emergency and pandemic preparedness science center. And this is based on the One Health concept, that we have to see to it that we join the challenges in human health with animal health and planetary health. So I'm really looking forward to this collaboration. This is the most pressing challenge of our time. Thank you.
Thank you too. Merci, Ole Petter Ottersen, le président.
Thank you, Ole Petter Ottersen, president of the Karolinska Institute in Sweden. Let's move on to Michel Kazatchkin, special envoy to the UN. Thank you. Indeed, now we have to think global health. We have seen that a crisis like COVID is also a crisis of governance, of world governance. It is a political and a security crisis. Consequently, the One Health concept must lead us beyond the cooperation of WHO, FAO, AHO. They may sign memoranda of understanding, but we must aim at a high-level reflection on the One Health concept and the interdependence concept in order to go beyond that cooperation. Also, locally, we must integrate that approach in the management of our towns, of our local communities, in order to associate public decision makers with scientists, but also with citizens, citizen groups, and associations, as they have the experience of the interface between man and the environment in the given context. I imagine that the experts will be working on all those themes, but it is important to stress the importance of those two. Thank you, Michel Kazatchkin, special envoy to the UN. I am now happy to welcome Professor Carlos Goncalo das Neves. You are research director at the Veterinarian Institute in Norway, the Norwegian Veterinary Institute. How can one bring this One Health concept to the political agenda? How do you think this should be done? How will you deal with this project within your group?
Bon après-midi de la Norvège et merci pour l'invitation.
Hi everyone from Norway.
It's no longer a new topic for most of us. It's something we've been burning for many years. But what COVID has perhaps shown us finally is an alignment of different stakeholders acknowledging that One Health is relevant. Politicians, private sector, industry, financial, people on the streets. This is the time to act. But these alignments don't last long. So it is extremely important that we stay on course and we actually now provide those who have the power to decide with a united message. So how do we address politics here and politicians with a united voice? And there is no doubt that there is a lot happening. As we speak, ESOC is now sitting in the United Nations. We will have Kunming, we will have COP26, the Food Summit. Several initiatives are taking place and will take place in the months and the year to come. And One Health has made it there. So now we need to give these people a joint united plan. And suddenly One Health is something everyone wants to do something about. So I hope this platform and the work in this group can help provide a united vision to these people that have the power to make a change. But let's be honest, if they do make a change, this will be a transformative or a disruptive change and it will cost money. And this takes me to the second and last point I'd like to make today. This means that the best way to ensure politicians stay on course is to have everyone with us. The people there out in the streets, the private sector, the financials. And this takes me to education and awareness raising and the power of media. If 30 years ago, education was for parents and for teachers to do, today the digital solutions make news run faster than ever before. We are launching this platform with Euronews, not on a joint publication on Nature or Science. Media has to no longer be just a vehicle to explain something, but a constructive part of this One Health plan. You can help us put the facts out, but as we've seen in COVID and in this infodemic, fiction runs as quickly and spreads as quickly as the virus. So let's take you also, all of you media, on board with this one single solution for a One Health challenge. Merci.
Merci à vous.
Thank you to you, Professor Carlos Goncalves Neves. Indeed, Eric Kant, a new lever, the role of the media to involve the media so that the message is spread. Our last guest is Hélène Delisle, Professor Emeritus at the University of Montreal. What lever should be used in order to move this One Health approach forward?
Well, first of all, thank you very much for inviting me. It's a pleasure to participate in this fantastic forum launch of the program. Do you hear me?
Yes, of course.
Tout okay,
à fait. Nous entendons très bien, Hélène.
Merci, merci. So I hope to be able to contribute to this challenging working group through my past experience in training, in research, in communication, and in field action in nutrition at the interface of agriculture, food, and health, of course. In my view, what's needed is renewed awareness, renewed thinking, and renewed action. Now, several aspects have already been mentioned, including the six pillars described by Dr. Comte. So I'll be very brief. Renewed consciousness requires sustained advocacy at all levels to make people more aware of the urgency of action at all levels. Urgency of change. Now, what's more important in my view is the need for renewed, innovative, creative thinking. Why not lateral thinking, according to De Bono? Not only going beyond silo thinking, but also beyond system thinking to move toward trans-system thinking. How can the main systems involved in OSH better work together, in particular agriculture and food system, environmental system, and health system? How can these still separate worlds, public, private, of course, but government, intergovernment bodies, foundations, coalitions, academia, NGOs, work together? All these have to be represented in our group. I would think that it was easier, in my experience, to achieve collaboration and intersectoral action at community level, micro level, more than at a more global level. So, if you are up to the challenge, join our group. The third point is renewed action. Of course, there's an abundance of ideas, platforms, conventions, agreements, objectives, targets, policies, strategies. The task is likely to prioritize those approaches, actions, and tools that appear most effective at global level, and in particular, those that reduce inequities. And this can be better done in the light of policy and implementation research, which needs to be sustained. Thank you very much.
Voilà cet appel d'Hélène Delisle, une nouvelle vocation pour que
that was the voice of Hélène Delisle advocating the work of this fifth group and asking all of goodwill to join the group. The different guests actually have identified different ways to work. The guests were Eric Cantola, Peter Anderson, Andrea Van Claire and Carlos Goncalo Desneves, and last but not least, Hélène Delisle. Thank you.